Let's continue and place a second camera on the opposite side of the building. Together with the first camera, they make up a path. The handles on both sides of the cameras can be moved to change the path shape. Display the view of the second camera. Navigate in the 3D view using the orbit and pan options to adjust it. Once the desired view is achieved, please select Camera 2 in the project map. Right-click and select the Modify this camera to current view option. Display the floor plan view. Display the camera settings dialog. Click on the Path button to open the Path Options dialog. Enter walkthrough for the path name. Set the number of in-between frames to 100. Click OK. Please notice that now the path is smoother on the floor plan. Open one of the camera views. Right-click into the 3D window and select 3D window settings from the menu. Set the width of the window size to 600 in the upcoming dialog. Click OK. The 3D window is now smaller. Double-click on the camera view again in the project map to make sure that the building fits the new window size. Select Document, Creative Imaging, Create Fly-Through from the menu. Choose the QuickTime Movie File option. The source should be the 3D window. Click the Set button and set the frame rate to 15. Click OK to close the Compression Settings dialog. Click Save and enter a name for the fly-through movie in the upcoming browser window. Save the movie in the exercise folder. The movie is being created and will take a minute or so depending on the available computing power. We can also create such a movie using the photo rendering window. In that case, it would take longer because the in-between frames would need to be calculated one by one. You may open the saved movie to view the walkthrough. Please resize the 3D window. Finally, let's present the building in a more artistic freehand style. Once again, select the Document, Creative Imaging, Photo Rendering Settings menu. Select the Sketch Rendering Engine at the top. Click the Size to 3D Window button. Open the Basic Settings panel. Here we can select different pens and pencils as line styles. Select the Vintage 52 sketch style from the list. Display the Background panel. And select White for both sky and ground. Click OK to close this dialog. Select the Document, Creative Imaging, Photo Render Projection from the menu to render the content of the 3D window using the Sketch Rendering Engine. Feel free to experiment with different settings, pen types, line thicknesses and colors in photo rendering settings. You may set up other views, zoom into details, and create other rendered images with the Lightworks Rendering Engine too. Finally, we would like to hide cameras on the floor plan. Display the floor plan view. Select both cameras on the floor plan. And click on Path in the Camera Settings dialog. Set the display options to None. Click OK to close the Path Options dialog. And notice that the cameras are not displayed on the floor plan. Close the Camera Settings dialog.